Mysterious, legendary, powerful, secretive. All of these descriptions fit Rheinmetall in one way or another. Its main product is ultra-modern weaponry. Let's lift the veil of secrecy and see what the mysterious techno-giant from Dusseldorf actually produces. But first, let's remember where this company came from. Its history dates back to the end of the century before last. In 1889, the talented engineer and entrepreneur Heinrich Erhardt founded Rheinische Metallwaren und Maschinenfabrik. And from the very beginning, its task was to fulfill orders from the military. In the following years, the company experimented with the production of ammunition, as well as various types of small arms, artillery, and components for automobile equipment. By 1914, Erhardt's company, nicknamed the Cannon King, had become Germany's largest arms manufacturer. Some 48,000 employees ensured the daily production of millions of cartridges and shells, hundreds of small arms, and dozens of artillery pieces. After the end of World War I, as a result of the peace treaty, Germany ceased production of large caliber weapons, and Erhardt's company, laying off half of its workers, refocused on the production of civilian machinery, including counting machines. By 1924, the company was restructured, becoming state-owned and named Rheinmetall. In the 1930s, the company, already under the name of Rheinmetall Borsig, returned to its focus on armaments production, and in the 1940s, experienced a period of tight integration with the Wehrmacht. By the end of World War II, the number of employees exceeded 80,000. Of course, with the end of the war, the company's activities were radically restricted. In 1951, however, the company was revived again, this time in the most peaceful form, with the production of transportation and household appliances. Instead of shells and cannons, refrigerators and steam boilers began to come off the assembly lines. But the return to the roots did not take long. Already in 1956, the word Borsig disappeared from the name of the company. This division was sold. It still exists today and is engaged in the production of industrial equipment. In the following decades, Rheinmetall itself grew, acquired several other companies of different profiles, and is now a public company whose shares are traded on the Frankfurt Stock Exchange. What products are produced at Rheinmetall plants today? First of all, they are military equipment, weapons and ammunition. In addition, the company's product range includes electronics, spare parts and components for machinery. But you're bored of hearing about pumps and bearings, so let's talk about the industrial giant's most impressive products. Modern armored vehicles. This tank was developed by Krauss Maffei Wegmann back in the 1970s, and more than 3,600 have been produced since then. Now Rheinmetall is in the process of modernizing these vehicles. Leopards have many modifications and can be equipped with both 120 and 140 millimeter guns produced by Rheinmetall. In 2023, several European countries have agreed to deliver at least 60 Leopard 2 tanks of the A4 and A6 modifications to help Ukraine's armed forces fight the Russian invasion. This is the latest model of the main battle tank being developed by Rheinmetall Landsystem. Inheriting the hull and power pack from the Leopard 2SO, the new model will be lighter, more autonomous, and more technologically advanced. Armament on board includes a 130mm smoothbore gun with automatic ammunition feeding system, as well as a twin large caliber machine gun with fully remote control, a thermal imaging site with a laser rangefinder, panoramic cameras, and onboard drones for reconnaissance and target acquisition are not a complete list of modern technologies used in the KF-51. Serial production of the tank has not yet begun, and potential production facilities are still under discussion, with the option of building a modern tank factory in Ukraine being considered. Modern modular APC, in-house developed by Rheinmetall. Tracked vehicle weighing up to 44 tons with a crew of 3 men and a troop of 8 men. It has both passive and active defenses against anti-tank weapons, fragmentation artillery, chemical, biological, and other threats. In addition to the two main modifications, the APC is also available as the Lynx V120 fire support vehicle. The family of amphibious assault vehicles includes several modifications: an anti-tank vehicle with a TW2 missile system, a fire support vehicle with a 20mm cannon, an air defense version with an anti-aircraft cannon, or a Stinger missile system, as well as a mortar and reconnaissance vehicle. Such a light mini-tank is very mobile and can be fully accommodated in a CH-53 transport helicopter for subsequent landing. In addition to well-known and universal vehicles, Rheinmetall also produces specialized machines that not everyone has heard of. For example, Keeler is a development of the 90s of the last century, a 53-ton demining tank based on the M48 Patton hull. Thanks to a special device, the machine is able to clear anti-tank and anti-personnel mines from a strip 4.7 meters wide and 120 meters long in just 10 minutes. At least four such tanks were transferred by Germany to the Ukrainian military in early 2023. Let's finish our short review with an even more exotic piece of military equipment. This armored vehicle has no armament unless you count the smoke grenade launcher, but it can help other vehicles to cross obstacles on the terrain. The Biber can span gorges or bodies of water with a bridge up to 2 meters long and 4 meters wide. The bridge takes only 2 to 3 minutes to assemble, and it can support up to 55 tons of load, which means it is suitable for crossing obstacles for almost any armored vehicle. Biber vehicles are part of the military aid package to Ukraine, and several of them are already helping to repel Russian aggression on the front. Would you like to know more about this and other military equipment? Write in the comments and subscribe to not miss new videos. Most of them are more peaceful, but we listen to your wishes and tell you about the most current technical trends.